Hi, my name's Suzanne, and I'm a tech writer here at F5. Today I'm going to show you how to create an instance of BigIP VE, or Virtual Edition, in the AWS console. So to get started, I'm going to come into the console here and create a VPC with a single subnet. I'm going to use the wizard and just create a simple VPC. I'm going to use my name since I'm in an environment with a bunch of other people. And just select the defaults. Click Create. When it creates the VPC, it also creates a security group for the VPC. And let's see if I can find mine. There it is. I'm going to actually put my name here so I can see it more easily going forward. And I'm going to look at the security group rules here. Right now, it's saying that the source is the security group itself, but I've had a little bit of trouble with this in the past. So although this isn't the safest thing, I'm going to save it like that for now. And outbound is also allowing all traffic. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is create an instance of a Microsoft Windows machine with a web page on it. I'm going to create that within my VPC just so I can show you how to send traffic to that web server. So I'm going to pause the video for just a minute while I spin up that instance, and then I'll rejoin you in just a minute. Okay, I created an application server, as you can see here. It's got a private IP address and a public IP address. Now the next thing I want to do is deploy an instance of BigIP in the same VPC. So I'm going to search in the marketplace for BigIP hourly. And you can see here there's different throughput limits. That's the max throughput that you're going to get. And then there's also good, better, and best. Those are different license types provided by F5, and there's documentation about that. So maybe do a little research before you get started. Let's see, I'm going to do a gig better, and that's sort of a middle one, and I am in Northern California. Click continue. Basically, it's hourly, that's the version number, and again, I'm in Northern California, so I'm going to launch with the console. Now it's giving me some suggestions about which instance type to use. Again, there's some documentation you can read. I'm just going to pick this one. Now here's where I'm going to pick my VPC that I created with my one subnet. Everything else I'm just going to leave as the same. It's going to auto-assign me an IP address. And let's see. Just going to accept the default. I'm going to call this Suzanne Big IP so that I can find it more easily. I'm going to select the VPC security group, which has everything open to be a little more secure. Actually, let's create our new security group. So by default, and I'm going to call this the Big IP group, and I got to put my name on it because I'm sharing here with other people. So right now it's allowing me to connect via PuTTY, you know, port 22. I'm going to add a couple more. I'm going to do HTTPS because the configuration management utility is initially going to be available on that port. And then eventually I'm going to want to access the virtual server traffic that way. So I'm going to add that one. And then I'm going to also do a custom one. I'm going to move the management port, the one that you use to access the configuration utility on 443. I'm going to move that to 8443 so that I can use that to access management. So I'm going to keep these three rules. And let's keep going here. Just keep accepting the defaults and launch. Have my key pair, and I acknowledge that I have it. All right, my instance is launching. I'm going to pause it here for another minute while it spins itself up. Actually, I realize that as it's spinning itself up, I want to assign a public IP address to it so that it can get licensed with F5. So I'm going to go to Elastic IPs. I'm going to allocate a new address, grab this address. Now I'm going to associate it with an instance And I believe it's this long and crazy one. Let me cancel and go back. Instances, my big IP is, starts with 0C5. So I go back here, I'm gonna associate this with 0C5, okay. All right, it's associated. So now what that means is that my big IP instance has a public IP address that when this is initializing, it can go out, license with F5, and then we're gonna use this address to connect to the config utility, and then eventually we're gonna use the same address as the virtual server address. Okay, so now my big IP is up and running, and the first thing I wanna do is set a strong admin password for it. So I'm gonna open up PuTTY, and when I first do this, I need to grab my key. Oh boy, which one? This one. So now I can connect. And it authenticated me with the key, which is great. So now the next thing I want to do, change my password. Give it a strong password because 443 is accessible from the internet right now. Okay, now that I can access it, I'm gonna do the next part, which is look at the config utility. So this allows me to manage my big IP, and again, it's on port 443 right now. So I had just set my admin password. Okay, now I'm gonna run through a couple quick steps here. Now you can enable and disable modules on this page. Now it's put a host name for me. I can keep that or set my own. And then I'm gonna re-enter my admin password. Now I log back in. Okay, the next thing I want to do is change the port for the management utility to 8443 so that I can use 443 for traffic to my web application. So I'm going to go back into PuTTY here, and I'm going to run some TMSH commands. Now these are documented in the documentation, so I'm just going to go kind of quickly here. But the main idea is that I want to change the port for management so that it's set to 8443. And now you can see in the background, it's logged me out because I'm no longer going to be able to connect using 443. I'm going to have to use 8443. Let me just look here. Okay, it's got HTTPS, this PC sync. That's what I'm expecting to see in the list. So I'm going to save it. Okay, and now when I come back in here, I have to connect using 8443 from now on. Okay, the next thing I want to do here is create a virtual server and a pool so I can serve traffic to my application through this IP address, through the big IP. So I'm going to go back in here and look at my instances. Let's see. Okay, here's my application server instance, and its private IP address is listed here. So I'm going to copy this. Now I'm going to go and create a pool with that application server as the member. Gonna do HTTPS, and throw the address here, port 443, add it to my list, and click finished. Great, now I've got my pool. Now the big IP has this private IP address. This is what I'm gonna use for the virtual server. Create a virtual server. And I add the address there. Now I select the HTTP pool, client SSL, server SSL, SNAT automap, and finally pick my pool. And my virtual server's up and running. So now what I'm gonna be able to do, whoops, is grab this IP address. And now traffic to my application server is going to be coming through here. Now, don't get too excited. I've got an exciting web page that I created. So now you can see that traffic to this public IP, which is the IP address of the big IP, is actually going straight through the big IP and to my application server. Now you can add whatever additional services you want in the big IP. This was just a quick way to show you how traffic goes through the big IP. Thanks for listening. Have a great day.